Would you like to spend less time physically writing out checks so you could manage your sore throat or cold? In that case, you should use the QuickBooks Online Printing Checks feature. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Right now, you're spending time physically writing the checks as well as spending time physically recording the checks into QuickBooks. Now, when you physically write the checks by hand, it usually takes about 1 to 2 minutes per check. But if you have 500 checks per week, then most of a workday is spent just physically sitting and writing the checks. And when you're finished, you have to record them into QuickBooks regardless of whether you wrote them by hand or printed them out. Wouldn't it be better if you could only record the checks into QuickBooks and not have to spend any time writing the checks by hand? It would be great to just record them and print them from QuickBooks. That would save you at least half a day's work, and that's what we're going to learn right here. Printing checks from QuickBooks Online involves the following steps. First, you have to purchase the checks from Intuit, you know, the company that makes QuickBooks, and these checks are compatible with printing them from QuickBooks Online. Quite frankly, they're usually about the same purchase cost as buying a box of checks from a typical bank. When you record the checks into QuickBooks Online, you record them the same way that you would record a handwritten check, except you will click the little check mark that says print later. Now, after that, all the checks that you clicked print later will accumulate in the print checks window. And then you open up the print checks window to print the checks. Now, before we demonstrate this, there are two very important points that you must keep in mind. First, the balances change when the check is recorded, not printed. So your QuickBooks records will be the same. In fact, you can physically reprint the checks as many times as you want, and printing them will have no effect on the transaction that's recorded or the balances of any of the accounts or any of the areas of data. Printing the checks is not the same thing as recording them. Secondly, you should know that check numbers are actually assigned at the moment of printing, not when you're recording the check to be printed in the future. So you must make sure that the check number you enter into QuickBooks Online when you're printing the check is the same as the check, the number on the check that you physically place into the printer. That is an extremely important point. For example, let's imagine on April 5th, we're recording paying Staples $100 with a printed check for equipment. And then the next day, on April 6th, we actually print the check. And the number that we put in for the printed check was check number 61. Let's back up and just record the check and see what it looks like when we use the print later option. And here in the new transaction window, go to the column of vendors and click check. Now we already learned how to fill out the form for a check, but don't forget the date that we're doing is April 15th of 2017, which is the example year that we're using in our course. The payee is Staples, and we already discussed why the previous bills show up here. We can disregard this on the right because this check is not related to those bills. This is a new set of equipment that we're buying. So we will scroll down to the category or the account of equipment, and the money amount that we're paying is $100. Now the most important point is that you have to make sure that in this check we click the print later button. Notice when we click the print later button, we are no longer physically able to put a number in the check number field. That's because QuickBooks Online knows if we're going to print this later, we have no idea what the check number will be until we put the checks into the printer. And that's all we have to do. That's the only difference between the way we recorded checks before and the way we record checks that we're going to physically print from QuickBooks. Click Save and Close, and let's see what it looks like after it's recorded. We click the Reports menu, and we click Trial Balance, and the account in the trial balance that recorded this check as the last entered transaction is right up here, Cash and Bank. We double-click the balance to get a list of every transaction, and when we scroll to the very bottom, we see that the April 5th check to Staples was the last one we recorded for $100. Notice it did change the balance even though we did not print it. But also notice there is no check number assigned to the April 5th check to Staples for $100. And that's because we have not yet printed it. On the very next day, April 6th, we actually print the check for Staples and we put check number 61 physically into the printer. Remember, there are no transactions or changes to the accounts or any area of data on April 6th. We're simply printing a transaction that we have already recorded. So, we go to QuickBooks Online. In the new transaction menu, in the column of vendors, we click Print Checks. Now, this will give us a list of every check that we indicated in the little box that we're going to print later, but have not yet printed. Now, in our example, the only one that we have is this April 5th check. So, what we would normally do is click the check mark in the margin for any check that we're actually going to print. And the reason it says starting check number is because sometimes we're printing several at once, and all it needs to know is the number of the first check in the printer, and it will assume all the other checks are in consecutive order. So I'm going to type in the check number, check 61, and now I'm going to click Preview and Print. Now I do not have a printer hooked up to my computer. I'm just clicking Preview so that we can see what it would look like if it printed, and then the printed preview does not actually include all the other things that are on the pre-printed check sitting in the printer. It'll only show you what it will physically print out as if it were printing on a blank page. But again, it's not. It's really printing on a pre-filled form, and everything fits into place. Now, when we click Close, it's asking us, did everything print okay? If not, then we would reprint or use one of these options here. Now, we still have to sign the checks, but again, if you get a little signature stamp, it's much easier if you're printing 500 checks a week. Click Done, and now let's take a look at what the check looks like in the account. We click again, Reports, Trial Balance, and then we go to the cash and bank account, double click, and when we scroll all the way to the bottom, you can see that this check that we made from April 5th has now been assigned check number 61 here in the computer. It may help you to see a second example where checks are printed in a batch. So let's imagine on April 6th, we recorded these three checks to be printed later, and make sure you choose the print later box. Now, Of course, you could pause the video and record these because you already know how to record checks. But as you do that, please remember to make sure that you click the Print Later button on each of these three checks. Go ahead and pause the video, and I will pause and enter them myself, and I will see you in a moment. And now that we've both recorded the checks, let's take a look at what they look like in the accounts. Reports, trial balance, go to the bank account where we wrote the checks from, click the money amount, and scroll to the very bottom. Notice these very last three checks that we just wrote for these correct amounts. These are the correct amounts, the correct accounts, the correct vendors, and the correct date. The only thing to notice is right now they do not have a check number assigned. That's because we have not yet printed them. So, now let's print them, and let's imagine that the first check that we put into the printer is check number 62, and you must put the checks into the printer in the order in which they come in the box from QuickBooks. So you will see it will be check number 62, 63, and 64. In the vendor column, we go down to where it says print checks. Notice there are three checks available to be printed because these are the only three checks we recorded where we put the little check mark in the to print later box. And these are checks that we check mark that box that we have not printed yet. That's why they're still here. So here we are starting with check number 62, and it will assign it in order. Now when we click preview and print, again, it shows us what it would look like if we printed it on blank paper. But we know whatever's missing here is really what's already printed on the check. We click the X in the corner to close the window, and we get this message: did everything print correctly? And again, if you need to reprint, you would click here. And if the entire thing was a mess, you would click here. But we're going to imagine everything's fine. So we leave the choice on top and we click Done. Now let's take a look at what they look like in the account. We come back to the cash and bank and scroll to the very bottom. You can see that they assigned check number 62, 63, and 64 to the three checks that we just recorded and printed. Another important point to note is that you must put the checks in the printer in the order that they came in the box when you ordered them from QuickBooks. If you do not, then the check numbers on the printed checks will be different from what's recorded into QuickBooks for those very same checks. And that, my friends, is a reconciliation nightmare. You would have to wait for the checks to clear in order to open them up after logging into your bank and see the photocopy of the cleared check and go through them one by one and reassign the check numbers by opening up each check and typing in the correct check number. Believe me, it's a nightmare. Be very careful after the checks print that the numbers on the printed checks are the same on the very same checks in QuickBooks. And one final note, you can always reprint a check and it will not have any effect on your accounts or any area of data in QuickBooks Online. All you have to do is just reopen the check and click the To Print box. So, here we are back at the three checks that we just printed, but let's imagine we want to print this one again, number 64. So all you have to do is double click to open it up, scroll over here. Now, it thinks that it should be check 64, but let's imagine right as soon as we mailed it out, somebody spilled coffee on it. So we shredded it up and put in the garbage. We reopen what we already print, what we told QuickBooks we already printed. Now just click this box to print. That's all you have to do. And again, click Save. That's it. Now, when you come here and you go down to Print Checks, you can see that only that check has been put back on the list, and QuickBooks assumes that it's the next consecutive check. You would type in here whatever check number is on the check that you physically put into the printer. Let's assume it's check 65. Print and preview. Again, this is what it would look like if it prints on blank paper, but we know there's more stuff on the check because you put that in the printer. And when we come back, ask if it printed okay, click done. And now when we go back to the accounts, we can see there's a new check number assigned to that check.